Hello everyone! Greetings from Kharkiv, Ukraine. My name is Svetlana Mukha and I'm the leading matchmaker and dating coach at Dealer.com. Today I would like to speak to you about different expectations regarding a relationship status and regarding our dating partner. We are all unique because we come from a different background, we went to different schools, our families are quite different, we have a different circle of friends, and if we are speaking about international dating, we also come from different cultures and different countries. Of course, you shouldn't forget about the difference in the male and female perspective regarding relationship and dating. You can like it or not, but women and men are quite different. Our needs, our ways to express and accept love will be really different. And of course, our attitude to relationship status will also be different. I will share a story with you to express what I mean. Not so long ago, I had an interview with a gentleman. He was from the United States in his early 40s. And during this interview, he shared a story with me. He was corresponding for about 5 weeks with a lady from Ukraine. He has met her on a free online dating site, and she was just 33. They were exchanging at first casual messages for a few weeks, but after, in his opinion, really meaningful two video calls, he was quite sure that she was the one. Not only she was the youngest from his online dates, and yes, she was 33 and he was in his 40s, and this gentleman did not use any paper letter dating sites, so at a free online dating site, his youngest conquest was really 33. So not only she was the youngest, she also spoke really good English, and she even worked for the international company which had the head office in his city. So in his mind, if things worked well for him and this lady, she could transfer to the head office without losing her job. So after talking to her on the video call, he was actually surprised that not only she looked like her photos in the profile, she even looked more beautiful. So after that, the gentleman was quite sure that she was the one. He went so far as stopping corresponding with other ladies at other online dating sites, and he bought tickets to Kyiv. They had two dates in Kyiv, and after the second date, the lady told him that she can meet him only in 3 days because she didn't expect him to come for more than a weekend, and they have discussed that he will fly over for a weekend, but he has actually decided to surprise her and to come over for a week, and in between they have agreed to text and to stay in touch. So being stuck in Kyiv alone, this gentleman has decided to do some sightseeing, to visit some museums, and he ended up going to the art gallery that this lady, his date, has mentioned a few times. So imagine his surprise when in this art gallery he ran into this lady on a date with another guy. And not only she has smiled to him, she even had the audacity to come over and to introduce her date to him, and he was really shocked. The same evening she has texted him telling that it was really uncomfortable and she didn't feel well about the whole situation, but she has agreed to this date even before he has traveled to Kyiv. And she didn't want to cancel on this date and she didn't feel comfortable about this. The gentleman was furious. He told me that he has accused her on being unfaithful, on playing him. And she was surprised with his reaction. She told him that she didn't think that they were exclusive yet. She didn't think that they were on the stage where they could discuss feelings and discuss the exclusiveness of their status. She told him that he was really a nice guy and they had two nice dates, but she was not sure. She was not sure about him, so of course she kept dating. The gentleman who has shared this story to me told me that he didn't expect that lady to betray him like that, because for her he has given up all his other correspondences. Of course, after her betrayal, he has tried to reach out to his other correspondences, but the majority of ladies have already moved on and have lost interest. So this gentleman is telling me that if he ends up hiring us, we have to make sure that the lady we introduce him to are ready to date him and only him. Let's discuss why this request is really unrealistic and not smart actually. In the mind of this gentleman, if he had a correspondence and or a date with a lady and he believed that they are compatible and he feels attracted to her, this lady automatically has to be on the same page. Of course, she has to find him as attractive and compatible as he finds her. And the whole idea that she can possibly date other people he finds sacrilegious. As you know, at Deola.com, we don't do correspondence or video chats between our clients prior to the face-to-face offline date. The gentleman and the lady meet each other on a real face-to-face date, and after that, of course, they can text, chat, do video calls in between their dates. No one can guarantee you that after the first date, the lady will fall in love so madly with you that she will delete all her dating apps from her smartphone. Actually, pretty often when the lady gives us the feedback after the first date that, oh, he's the one, he's my boyfriend, I have fallen in love, we start to be nervous together with our psychologist. Why? Because usually the gentleman after the same date gives us the feedback that he's not that sure about her, he's not sure he wants to go out with her again. Why? Pretty much because such an attitude of the lady is a bit obvious. It's a bit too obvious that she is already into him. And there is no sense to try to win her over anymore. There is no mystery. You don't have to try anymore. You don't have to chase her. Maybe it even makes this lady look a bit too obvious, clingy, and even desperate. And nobody wants to date someone desperate. It's always a bad sign. As a matchmaker, I can check, of course, that she is single and emotionally available for dating. But I can't guarantee that after three dates without the relationship status conversation, she will consider you her boyfriend. If it is important to you and after two dates you feel that she is the one and you don't want to meet other people, you want to concentrate on her and be exclusive, talk to her. Ask her if she feels the same way. If she feels the same way, if she tells you that she is excited to be exclusive with you and not to meet other people, then go for it. Of course, in this scenario, she will have to keep her word and not to meet other people. Also, it is important to discuss if being exclusive means to you that both of you delete your Tinder account or your profile from other dating apps. And don't forget that it is a two-way street. You can't expect her to delete her profile from dating sites while your profile will still be there. Also, it is important to discuss your relationship status before you start having sex. I always tell this to my Ukrainian female clients, because for a Ukrainian lady, if she's having sex with a gentleman, she will consider this a relationship. She will consider you her boyfriend. And if your intention is to have just a casual relationship, talk to her before you go intimate, before you have sex. This is the honest thing to do. I often tell in my videos that if you have met online and you were talking for a few weeks, even for a few months, but you have never met in person, you're not in relationship yet. And a normal, decent Ukrainian lady will not consider you her boyfriend. If after talking for a few weeks she claimed that she loves you, that you're her boyfriend, then expect a story about a sick grandmother, a broken iPhone, and request for money. Don't send any money, don't give any gifts, and stop talking to that person. That's not serious. Discuss your relationship status with the Ukrainian lady. For a decent, normal Ukrainian lady, it is important to understand where you stand. It is important to understand that you are in exclusive boyfriend-girlfriend relationship. Until you have this conversation, she will feel free to flirt with other people, to meet other people, to be on dating sites, and it won't make you indecent, cruel, or it won't make you a player. It is important to talk about your relationship. Guys, I hope it was useful for you, and I hope you understand now how important it is for a Ukrainian lady to discuss your relationship status. I wish you love from Deola.com, Svetlana Mukha.